In this variation of an ice table problem, we're going to see an example of how we can actually solve for an equilibrium constant value. So here we are given the reaction of the combination of nitrogen and hydrogen to make ammonia. Again, we're given the temperature. We are told that we have 0.75 molar nitrogen and 0.45 molar ammonia introduced into a closed container. Realize that those are our initial concentrations. So again, nitrogen is 0.75 molar and ammonia is 0.45 molar. Pay careful attention to which quantities you're told about. Notice we're not told anything about hydrogen here. So although rare, not impossible. Remember that a system will come to equilibrium no matter what combination we start with. So even though I don't start with hydrogen, this reaction will still happen. And now we're told that 0.30 molar hydrogen is measured in the container at equilibrium. So realize that that is our very final value for hydrogen. We first want to calculate all equilibrium concentrations for this reaction and then calculate a Kc value. So we know our initials. Our next step then is to determine the amount of change. So again, this is where it's helpful to draw a squiggly line under your arrows. And realize that since hydrogen has the value of zero, it has to increase. Any substance that starts with a zero has to increase. So I can never give you a quantity of zero for both a reactant and a product initially. Only one side of the equation can have zeros. So that means that both of my reactants have to increase and my product has to decrease. And remember, they're changing by a ratio of their coefficients. So I don't need the one for nitrogen, but you're welcome to put it in. Hydrogen is going to change by 3x, and ammonia is going to change by 2x. So at equilibrium, again, now we're just adding up our first two rows. For nitrogen, I have 0.75 plus x. For hydrogen, I just have a 3x. For ammonia, I have a 0.45 minus 2x. And then the last key thing to solving this problem is to recognize that our bottom two rows are equal, right? They're two ways of describing the same thing. The first of these two, I'm describing equilibrium concentrations based on the change from initial and change. The last one is my final actual quantity once I know my x value. What that means is I can use these two quantities from hydrogen and set those equal to each other. And so with this setup, it gives me another way to solve for x. So I now know that my x value is 0.10 molar. Since x is 0.10 molar, to solve for nitrogen, my setup here would be 0.75 plus x, which is 0.10, or a 0.85 molar. To solve for ammonia, I plug in my x value. I have 0.45 minus 2 times my 0.10. So this is 0.45 minus 0.20, or a 0.25 molar. So now I have a completed ice table. I have just calculated all equilibrium concentrations. Now I have enough information to solve for my Kc value. So going to a cleaner screen where we know these quantities. Again, we just figured out that this one was a 0.85 molar. We knew hydrogen was 0.35, and nitrogen was calculated as a 0.25. So our last step then is to write our equilibrium expression. So realize we didn't need this to solve the first part of the problem, but we do need it now. All right, products over reactants, coefficients are the exponents, and now I can plug in all of my known quantities. Oh, correctly. Sorry about that. Ammonia is squared, not cubed. So 0.25 squared products over reactants, 0.85 for nitrogen, 0.30 cubed for hydrogen. And now we simply plug numbers in to get an equilibrium constant. And for this one, we're going to 2 sig figs because all of our concentration values go to 2. Our final equilibrium constant for this reaction would be a 2.7.